Hi, I want to quickly show you how you can change the icons in our built-in skins. So I have four nodes here, so four panoramas or four nodes. I'm going to drag them in. Now these nodes are geolocated, so I'm just going to simply use tour, automatic linking, and closest node. What I want to do is add some more point hotspots for pop-ups. So pop-up image, pop-up video, etc. So to do that, I'm going to select hotspot viewer mode. So we now got the hotspot icon. And the first pop-up I'm going to add is an image pop-up. So I just drag the image into the viewer. Pano 2 VR knows it's an image. It's also using the skin ID of HT underscore image. This is important later. And I'm just going to paste in the title for this point hotspot. I've opened up a YouTube video. And to add a YouTube video or YouTube image video pop-up, you just literally navigate to the video, drag and drop it in and let go. You'll see that Pano 2 VR already knows it's a video. The source is YouTube. Again, the skin ID, we will touch on this later. And of course, the title. I'm just going to edit the title there. Okay, I'm just going to add a couple more hotspots. So let's go back to Firefox. And this time around, I'm going to add a URL hotspot. And I'm just going to edit the title there. Okay, and then the final hotspot I'm going to add is a wiki page. There we go. So I'm just going to do that and add that underneath. So that's all my point hotspots added, and the project's ready to go. So I'm going to add a web output. I'm going to select the feather orb skin, and we are now going to produce the output. When I click that, what happens is, because I haven't saved the project, Pano 2 VR will ask me to save before exporting. I'm going to click OK, and we're going to save it to our projects folder. Click save, and now Pano 2 VR will then proceed to create the output. So this is the output using the standard feather orb skin. You can see we've got a teal color. Because we've got a YouTube video, it's showing the sound splash screen. So if I click that, we're going to start the project with sound, and you can see our default colors and default icons. Okay, so there's the image pop up, and we've got the wiki page here. Okay, so what we're going to do then is look at a very basic thing we can do to change the appearance straight away is go into the skin configuration. Now, all of our default skins have got different configuration settings. The feather orb also allows us to change the accent color. You can see the same teal color here. So what I'm going to do is choose a location in the panorama to sample a color. I kind of like the orange one here, so we're going to sample that. So let's just move that to one side. And what I'm going to do is use the color picker. So I'm going to click, sample the color here. So this orange, click OK, and click OK again. And you'll see Pano 2 VR automatic with the live update. We can now see that we've changed the accent color. So straight away, we've made a big difference just by purely changing the color of the accent. Right, the other thing I want to show you is the custom hotspot image. We can change images ad hocly. So if I go back to the original panorama, or the start panorama, I'm going to select this wiki page or this wiki hotspot. And here you can see custom image. I'm going to use the open folder, and I'm going to select the Abby's logo here. Click OK or click open. And we are just going to save the project file, which will then create another live output. And here we can now see that we've got the logo. Here we go. So that can now open up the page with the logo. But note, it's only doing it per hotspot. It's not doing it globally. You can see that we've still got the other URL hotspot up here, and it's not changed. So what we need to do then is to go now head towards the skin editor. But first, before I do that, I'm just going to remove the hotspot here. So let's select it, right click, and clear the custom image. To open the skin editor, we're just going to quickly click the skin button. Here it is. And what we're going to do first and foremost is save the skin. So I'm going to use a keyboard shortcut to do that. Now, it says it's write protected, which is true. All of our skins are write protected. So we've got to save the skin in a different directory. So I'm going to click OK. And I'm going to add underscore mod. Here we go. Now, the save location is in Pano 2 VR skin directory. So if I want to use this skin again, I can leave it here. And every time I select a skin from Pano 2 VR's web output, this skin will be there as well. Or what I want to do is go to the desktop and save it to the projects folder. There we go. So I'm not cluttering up my Pano 2 VR build. And what I want to do is show you how we find the relevant hotspots. Now, we were talking about skin IDs earlier and how important these will be, or we need to look at them later. So the first one I want to look at is going to be this image pop-up. So if you look, it had the skin ID of HT underscore image. So if I now go back to the skin editor, you'll see that what we're looking for is HT underscore image, and here it is. If I expand its elements, we will start to see that we've got the HT image background. So if I open that up, and you can see now we've got the actual icons that we're now going to change. So this is our first job, if you like, in changing the icons, is one, identify where they are in the skins tree, so in this case HT image, and then we can keep expanding the elements until we find the images here. Now we've got two images, a dark image, and when we mouse over it, it turns into a light image. So to change this, what I want to do is change it to a darker, a more filled image. So I'm going to select one of them, and here it is in its properties. So this is the SVG's properties, and I can actually change it various ways, but what I'm going to show you first of all is in the components toolbox. And so this is what this button is. So when we click this, Pano 2VR ships with loads of buttons. So here's this image set, but what I want to do is change to the material, and it's got a much bolder set. So I'm just going to type in camera, and I'm going to select that. It then I can click OK, and we've now changed the icon. I'm going to do the same for the other image. So again, go there. I've already got the camera already set, so I'm going to click OK. Now you'll notice that it's a black image. So what I want to do is, with that selected, I'm going to go to the color tool and pick white and change that to white. Click apply, and that would now change the images in the output. So all I need to do now is just save the skin. That will update the output, and let's have a look, and you can now see that we've got a much bolder image there. What I want to do now is show you where you can find the other icons that make up the interface. Here we've got these buttons under here, and we've got these as well. So you've got all this button and the share button. So let's go back to the skin editor. And here we can see we've got, well, in this skin, it's called a safe area. It's a main container. But if you look, we've got the menu right, menu center, menu left. This was on the left-hand side. So if I expand that, menu left background. So these are the menu buttons here. And if I expand that even further, you can see the other icons that we're doing. Now they're showing them till, because that was their original color, but of course what we've done is change these colors when we changed the accent of the skin. So that's just showing you where you can find all the other icons in the skin. You've just got to hunt for them. We have them labeled up as menu left, menu right, etc. What I want to show you now is other ways you can get icons. Now, we found a website. I'm just going to open it up. And this is SVG Repro. And this was quite good. You can download the SVGs free, or you can buy packs of them. So we're just going to type in Panorama and see what it comes up with. Click on here. And what we've got is some quite nice looking icons. So I'm going to use these for, say, the point hotspot. So I'm going to download that one and this one. Now the reason why I'm downloading these two is because the point hotspot here has an icon, and when we hover over it, mouse over, we get the preview. But on a visited node, I want to show that we visited it. So I'm going to use this, if you like, unfilled version to show that we've visited that node. So that's a couple of icons there. I'm also probably going to search for YouTube, see what happens. Kind of like this one as well, so I'm going to click that and yeah, save for the download as well. Okay, so I've got a few downloads that I've done. And here you can see I've already downloaded a couple already, but just wanted to show you that you can go to the internet and download them. So let's just open up my downloads folder, and we're just going to drag and drop that lot in as well. All right, okay, done. Right, so I've now got a whole bunch of new icons. So let's carry on and updating the icons in the project. So let's go back to Panopto 2VR. I'm going to click on the hotspot here, and this one is going to be for the video. So again, I'm looking for HT underscore video YouTube. So let's go back to the skin. Look down here, and we've got it down. There we go, in the skins tree. If I expand on this, we can keep expanding until I get to the icons. Here we go. And we're going to do exactly the same thing. I'm going to select an icon. This time around, because I've got it in the projects folder, I'm just going to click change. I need to go to desktop and the project. It's the YouTube one, so I'm going to select that icon. You can see I've changed it. And I'm going to do the same for the white one. So go to change. There's the SVG. With it selected, it needed to be white. I'm going to use the color tool and just change that to white. Okay, and apply. So that's that point hotspot change. So if I save that, we'll see that in the output. There we go. So we've got a nice dark one now. And one of the things I haven't mentioned is when we change a hotspot in the skin, we're changing it globally. So the next one, just to prove the point, is going to be our point hotspots. Let's go back to Panopto 2VR. This is our point hotspot that's for changing nodes, so tour nodes. And you'll see that it's got the skin ID of HT underscore node. Go back to the skin. This is the hotspot that we want to find. So here it is. And we're going to use these new ones that we did. Now, remember what I said, we've got one that shows for the actual image, so for the actual hotspot itself. So I'm going to select that, and I'm going to change that. I'm going to change that to this one. Click OK. Now, this is like a bluey color, so I'm just going to make sure that that's black. OK. And what I'm going to do now is just save this, and that updates the output, and you can see that when we go to various locations, it's still black, but here where I visited it, we've changed the icon to the visited icon. So that's what I want to change. So let's go to the visit icon, select it, let's click change, and let's check change it to this one. Click open, and again, just going to check test the, or rather make sure that we're black, because that's the color scheme we're going on with this particular icon. Click save, and that should do us. So now if we have a look at the icon, we can see that we've got the on mouse over, we see the preview. Again, Panopto 2VR automatically does this, so as soon as you have a hotspot, it automatically includes the preview image for you. And when we now look back, we've now got our visited icon there. Okay, but the important thing about to remember here is when we use the custom image, we change it just for the one point hotspot. When we change it via the skin editor, we are changing them globally. What I want to do now is continue updating the other hotspot, which is going to be the URL hotspot. So I'm going to go back to the skin editor, and we're going to collapse the tree for the HT node and open up the HT underscore URL. And here what we're going to do is select the icons to change them. So let's just change a pair of those. This one's the white one, so that needs to be changed in the color tool. Here we go, and click apply and save. And what we're going to get now is, let's just create the output. And here we go, we have the output, and we've got the two for the point hotspot for the websites. There we go. So there's the one there and one for the wiki. Now what I want to do now is show you how we can duplicate or copy a point hotspot and give it a certain task. Now I've got a single URL hotspot, one for a website and one for a wiki page, but I want to create a unique one for wiki pages. So to do this, I'm going to go back to the skin editor. And what I'm going to do is just collapse that to keep it neat in the tree. And I'm going to copy and paste the whole URL, the whole hotspot template with all of its child elements. There we go. And what we're going to do is rename this to Wiki. And then I'm going to select the icons, and we can change these to use the Wiki icon. Here we go. So let's just do one. Let's do the white one. And obviously with the color tool, we need to change that back to white. And we're ready to go. Right, so that's the output. So let's just create that. And what you'll see is we've still got these two are the same, but I want to dedicate this one we've just created for the Wiki page. So the way we do that is we select the point hotspot. In the hotspot's properties, we've got skin ID. And what we're going to do is select the one we've just created, ht_wiki. And when we select that, that one hotspot now will use that template from the skin, and this one will use the default one, ht_URL. So let's create the output and have a look. There we go. So what we've now got is we can have our wiki URLs have their own hotspot, and the normal URL has its own hotspot as well. Anyway, that's how to change the icons in our default skins. And as always, thanks for watching.